At the opening ceremony of the 2014 Soccer World Cup in Brazil, a paraplegic Brazilian man kicked off the first ball of the tournament himself. The young man was wearing a so-called exoskeleton, a robot suit, whose movements he controlled using his thoughts. Professor Gordon Cheng from the Institute for Cognitive Systems at the Technical University of Munich is a leading partner in the Walk Again project.
We spent many months training a number of patients to see if we can actually get a exoskeleton to actually help them walk again or have the feeling of walking again.
2 years after the World Cup, the researchers of the Walk Again project published a notable study.
Over the last 2 years, the medical team has been able to continue a lot of this clinical trial with the patient. And what they have found is that there is actually physiologically and mental improvement to the patient. And they could actually gain some movement in their legs, which is very surprising for us.
A factor referred to as brain plasticity plays a role in this. Using training over a period of time, the brain can reorganize itself.
There's a lot of theory about body schema, which has a representation in our brain that tell us about our physical body, how it moves, how it sends, and with the appropriate training or retraining and rewiring of the circuits, allow the brain to actually readapt this body schema with a new mechanism such as exoskeleton.
One key element was tactile feedback, which makes it possible for the patient to feel ground contact with each step. Gordon Cheng and his colleagues at the Technical University of Munich developed an artificial skin for the purpose.
So we constructed a new generation of artificial skin. So this artificial skin, you can actually have a pre-touch sensing and also touch sensing. And also you can actually make a non-safe robot safe. This is a standard industrial arm. Usually it will not know if you're near it. And what we have constructed is an artificial skin that it's very, very sensitive to you. And you can actually control it with just very gentle touch. So on the exoskeleton, we place this on the foot of the exoskeleton. And that pressure sensing allowing the exoskeleton to actually detect every single footstep. And that footstep is sent information is sent back to a sensor suit, and that gives the sensor suit allow the patient to feel that every single step the exoskeleton is taking, and the feedback to the patient is through this sense. And their brains start to adapt and learn the sensation of actually taking steps.
Professor Cheng and his colleagues are already working on a new generation of the exoskeleton. This humanoid robot is helping.
Building human-like robot can actually help us build better robot for people, and also help us have a better understanding of people. And the better building robot is helping people with that. The robot will be much more closer to human, such as the exoskeleton. If we build a humanoid robot that walks, then the exoskeleton can actually benefit from that technology, or the walking algorithm that we develop for the humanoid robot can directly transfer into a exoskeleton that can actually help somebody walk again, and we gain mobility.